So for history, we have pages 128, 129 so in your work pick. So turn there first, if you haven't done it already, 128, 129. You see that you have ancient Greece. We're always talking about ancient Greece in this chapter. And on the left side, you have the main ideas. The Greeks and the blanks fought in the 5th century. That's on page 168. Isn't it nice they give you the page numbers? I mean, it's easy to find that. And then the blanks with the Persia had taken their toll on Greece. Now remember, when we just studied Persia, there was a lot of information in it that they could never completely defeat the Greeks. Remember, that was always the situation with them. Pericles helped restore the former blank of Athens. Pericles also used his blank in order in other areas. The Athenians believed that if the Greek city-states worked together, they would be blank. And then blank did not join the Delian League. And then some city-states joined Sparta and formed an alliance called the blank. Now, on the right side there on page 129, you don't have to do 130 right now. In fact, let's see, you will have to do it tomorrow. Probably tomorrow. The Spartan army surrounded the city of blank, and then Athens made naval attacks on Sparta's blank on the coast. Sparta won the war with blank, and then neither Sparta nor Athens ever fully blank from the effects of the war. And then at the bottom there, blank was a historian who wrote about the Peloponnesian War. All right, so now let's go ahead and read, starting on page 169. Try to follow along. If I read too quickly and you have a question, or you have a question about something I've read you don't understand, then go ahead and ask me later. Or ask me at that time, raise your hand, and I'll try to get my attention here. War and restoration, the Persian Wars. The Greeks clashed with the Persian Empire in the 5th century BC. Persians were angered by the growth of this Greek city-states. They wanted to conquer Greece and make it part of the Persian Empire. But they discovered that defeating the empire or the Greeks would not be easy. For over 10 years, the Greeks fought the Persians and won many battles. After the Athenian army won the Battle of Marathon, Sparta joined forces with Athens to fight the Persians in later battles. In the Battle of Thermopylae, the Greeks suffered a defeat and watched Athens go up in flames. But the Greek spirit was not defeated. One of the most decisive battles was the Battle of Salamis in 480 BC. The battle took place at sea when the Greeks met the Persian forces. The Greeks lost about 40 ships, but they burned at least 200 of the Persian ships and won the battle. The Persians tried only one more time to conquer the Greeks, but were unsuccessful. Greece was victorious. However, war had taken its toll on Greece. Many buildings lay in ruins. One of the first ways the Greeks put their new confidence to work was in restoring their cities. Pericles, a powerful speaker and politician, loved the city of Athens. He had grown up in Athens and wanted it always to be a city that others would admire and love as much as he did. After the Persian Wars, he wanted to repair the damages caused when the Persians burned the city. Pericles helped restore the former beauty of Athens. He encouraged the Athenians to rebuild the ruined temple and to construct other sacred buildings on the Acropolis. He hired talented architects, sculptors, and artists. Under his leadership, the architecture of the classical age took shape. Columns, sculptures, and the great entrance gate were built. Pericles also supported the growth of manufacturing and trade, and he helped strengthen the military. Because of his influence during the 5th century BC, the period is often called the Age of Pericles. All right, next page is about the Peloponnesian War. Growing tension. After the Persian Wars, Athens took steps to protect itself and its trading practices. Athens had a strong navy, but the Athenians knew they were not strong enough by themselves. They wanted to be able to defend their city-state against other world powers like Persia. Athens believed that if the Greek city-states worked together, they would be stronger. Athens formed an alliance with many city-states. The alliance was called the Delian League. The city-states agreed to pay money into the league's treasury to help protect each other. They also contributed troops and ships. The dominant power of the League was Athens. It had the most control over the Aegean Sea, where the Greeks traded. Taxes were paid to Athens to maintain its navy. Later, Athens also received payments for guarding the League's treasury. As a result, the city-state grew wealthier and more powerful. Sometimes Athens pressured other city-states to join or stay in the League. Many Greeks thought that Athens wanted to build an empire and control the rest of Greece. Sparta did not join the Delian League. Athens and Sparta disagreed on many things, including their forms of government. Sparta felt that Athens was using the Delian League to gain power. Tensions grew between the two city-states. Some city-states took sides with Sparta and formed an alliance called the Peloponnesian League. Finally, in 431 BC, Athens and Sparta went to war with each other. Their allies joined the fighting, because most of the fighting took place on the Peloponnesus. On the Peloponnesus, the war is called the Peloponnesian War. It lasted more than 27 years. That's a long war. I think the longest any of our wars have ever lasted has been about 4 or 5 years that we've been involved in the United States. Of course, they didn't have nuclear bombs back then either, so that probably made a difference. The Siege of Athens. The Spartan army marched to Athens and surrounded the city. The Spartans settled in for a siege, hoping that the Athenians would eventually begin to starve. There would be nothing for the Athenians to do except surrender. But even inside its city walls, Athens was not cut off from its seaport. The Athenian army supplied the city with food and other needed items by way of the sea. The siege lasted until a plague broke out in Athens. Many Athenians died, including Pericles. The Spartans left because they did not want to catch the disease themselves. Because that's one way to get rid of them, right? Just make everybody really sick. Battle by land and sea. The Athenian navy continued the war by attacking Sparta's allies on the coast. Both sides won some battles and lost others. Neither Athens nor Sparta could gain the advantage. Finally, both agreed to a truce. The defeat of Athens. The truce lasted only a few years. Athens broke it by attacking Sicily, one of Sparta's allies. Sicily defeated the powerful Athenian fleet. Then Sparta joined forces with the Greeks' old enemy, the Persians. Persia began giving money to Sparta, and Sparta was able to build a navy of its own. The Spartan navy took control of the Hellespont, blocking Athenian ships from bringing food and supplies into Athens. In 404 BC, Athens was forced to surrender. Sparta had won the war. Consequences of the war. Sparta took control of Greece for about 30 years, but neither Sparta nor Athens ever fully recovered from the effects of the war. Both city-states had been weakened by their losses. The weaker city-states had once looked to Sparta for protection, but now they found it to be an oppressor. Many people had died. Buildings lay in ruins. Farmland had been ravaged. Athens lost its democracy and found it difficult to submit to Spartan oligarchical rule. Uprisings caused Sparta to lose control over the Greek city-states, leaving disunity once again. The glory that was Greece would never return. And then you have Thucydides, who's a famous historian, wrote a lot about things that happened during that time. And it says everything we know, or much of what we know, of the Peloponnesian Wars comes from him. As an Athenian general, he witnessed the war firsthand. And he wrote, from direct knowledge and careful research, he tried to verify each fact he wrote, and he recorded one of Pericles' most famous speeches during the war. The speech was given at a funeral for an Athenian soldier who had died in battle. All right, that's it. You can stop it now. Thank you. Oh.